I was diagnosed in 2005. I was diagnosed with lung cancer.
And so they told me that it was cancer, and was a real shock.
Well, I was diagnosed with prostate cancer in, when I was 55, so it's been 15 years ago.
I feel fine.
So I went 5 years, and my PSA stayed down to, you know, undetectable. And then I remember Dr. Parton said, if it goes above 0.1, you've got advanced prostate cancer. Well, it did. So I came up and talked to Dr. Gulley, and Dr. Gulley said, we'll take care of you. You know, there's no doubt in my mind that he has your best interest at heart. I've asked him, I said, I'm your dad, okay? I'm your dad. What would you tell him to do? He said, exactly what I'm telling you to do, and never hesitate.
So really what we're trying to do is we're trying to design vaccines that can help the body's immune system recognize and attack the tumor cells. These two vaccines are what we refer to as pox viral vaccines. One primarily that we use for prostate cancer, and another that we use for a variety of different cancers.
Well, it's been great. As far as, you know, I'm getting four injections, four, you know, parts of the body, and it's no worse than a flu shot.
Our patients, in general, love the idea of a therapeutic vaccine. They love the idea that their immune system is getting in there and helping them fight the cancer. What I've noticed is that patients may not see dramatic shrinkage of the tumors, or the tumor markers may not go down right away, but there is a stabilization in many patients. We had a patient with breast cancer who had a previous vaccine before she came to this study, had progressed on that, and then came on to our study, got a vaccine, and actually the tumor, which was in her chest, in a lymph node in her chest, which was rather large, shrunk down and is now completely gone.
This coming June, it'll be 5 years that I've maintained my great status. I know that a lot of people, after going through chemotherapy, the last thing that they want to do is another treatment. But a lot of these treatments, and especially vaccine trials, they're showing to have a great effect on being able to keep someone from recurring.
And so by training the immune system, one can potentially impact the outcome of the patient long after the vaccine has been given, and that immune system, once trained, has the potential to continue to fight that tumor for the rest of the patient's life.
The staff have been great. Dr. Gulley's been great. Everyone's really good at answering the questions.
I love it. I really enjoy coming here every month. I know that sounds really weird. I think that really my greatest fear is not necessarily recurring, because I know that eventually, at some time down the line, something will recur and I'll need to change treatments. And that's not even my worst fear. My worst fear is leaving the people here, like my team here.
The research nurses and the nurse practitioners, I mean, people examining it, it just couldn't be any nicer. Couldn't be any nicer. You got to come down here and give them a chance. And if you give them a chance, they do the best. They give you the best that they can possibly give.